And welcome back, everybody. Aesop, Grimm here, and this is the continuation of our Subnautica Below Zero Relics of the Past Chronicle. And if we look at our info here, our primary mission right now comes by way of our sister's colleague. Our sister died in suspicious manner, and we're investigating that. And it's in the last paragraph where she tells us that because she's been decontracted, she lost her contract with Altera, she has lost all information access, and so we ourselves may be much better choice to investigate this because we can come in under the radar. And she tells us, this is Lillian Bench, she tells us if we're able to, Delta Station was their HQ, and they were in a big hurry to leave, and there might still be information to be found there, and it has a big radio tower, impossible to miss. So that's our number one, our initial big-time overarching goal. But in order to get there, we first have to do some of these things. We've done most of this stuff. We're right now basically here and here. We need to construct necessary survival equipment using the habitat's fabricator, and we need to gather resources in order to do that. But before we do even that, we need to go get food. So, we'll exit the base and do some fishing. Come here, anglefish.
New creature discovered.
We got a peeper. These fish look a little bit bigger than I remember them being in Subnautica, but I might be wrong. There we go. Okay, that's two. I want about three of these floaters if I can to make water. I think they're called floaters. Okay, now we need to get back
oxygen.
From... We're under an ice shelf. We need to get up here and grab oxygen. Okay, other floaters. Here's one. And there was a second one nearby there. Okay, that's a total of three.
Oxygen.
And I think that's gonna be enough. Okay. I was gonna try and gather some resources there because I thought that might have been a copper node. But it looks like it wasn't. All right, let's make breakfast. Or dinner. I don't know what time it is right now. Okay, we're good to go on food. Good to go on water. Okay, now, first things first, we need an O2 tank and we need a fin. So we need silicon rubber, fiber mesh, and two titanium. Fiber mesh, we need a knife for, and that comes from creep finds. Silicon rubber comes from the clusters. Oh, I like this. We can pen recipes. I just now saw that. Pin this, and pin this. I'm going to need a knife. Okay, so our first foray is going to be to get seed clusters. We need three things of rubber and one titanium. All right. Then we'll be able to cut the creep vine that we need to make the fins. Might as well
should be
grab,
able to use this.
Grab the quartz. Here's a copper outcropping, limestone outcrop. I think that was titanium. Okay. Let's see. Get up for oxygen. And I'm looking for creep vine. Ah, there's some in the distance. Looks like we got a sunset happening. That's pretty. It does get pretty saturated. I actually kind of think that's a little bit ugly. I like the sunsets in the original Subnautica a lot more. But I'm also not sure what kind of environmental effects might be at play here. Okay, we're gonna need two of these. Maybe three. There we go.
New blueprint synthesized.
How am I doing on O2? Okay, I can dive. A Galena outcrop. We just got iron. That's different. More limestone, more copper.
Oxygen.
Okay, we're 12 meters down. We gain oxygen pretty rapidly when we break the surface of the water. But it also feels like it's a little bit less forgiving. Like, when you're low on oxygen, you're seriously low. It feels like it goes a little bit faster than the original Subnautica. I don't know if that's true or not.
I was a little nervous about dropping into an unknown area, but luckily, this biome seems to have an abundance of minerals I can use for tools and upgrades. I didn't want another situation like Byzantos 5. When Xenoworks dropped me off, there were barely any resources. I survived off the land for 3 months with just a knife, my lucky PDA, and some rope. I am still kind of proud of that, though.
Okay. So our girl here, Robin, she's evidently got special training. She's a survivalist. What I'm kind of hoping for, although if they leave it unsaid, how do I phrase this? They could leave it unsaid as no explanation as how she got this training. It's just left us to infer that she's highly trained, and that would be okay. But if they end up going down a road of what's called a Mary Sue, where you have a female heroine character and for cultural reasons you have to make her perfect and overpowered, nobody likes that. There's a tried and true methodology of writing a script that's been around since way before computers. It's a novel technique, from what I understand. It's called the hero's journey, and the whole thing is about overcoming flaws, character flaws, being in vulnerable situations. That's what makes things exciting, and that's what people tie into. But because of overzealous, well-intentioned people is how I would describe it, you instead wind up with this Mary Sue kind of approach to things. I've heard nothing but good things about this game, so I suspect they're either going to flesh this out, or it's not going to go down a road that ends up being super overpowered, and there's going to be some degrees of where she's scared, or there's points of vulnerability, et cetera, et cetera. I just thought, you know, I hope they don't mess it up. This has been a neat story so far, and I hope they don't mess it up with lazy writing. But basically, we've learned that we're in a resource-rich environment. Let's fabricate our silicon rubber. Now, I've got one more that I'm going to make into a lubricant if I can. Let's go make our tools first. So I need fiber mesh for the O2 tank. I can make the fins.
Finally, some speed.
I still have enough to make the survival knife, which will allow me to get the mesh, and that means I should be able to go ahead and fabricate a lubricant. Okay. Now, let's see. Go here, here, here. I can unpin that because I have it now. And I can unpin this. All right. How are we doing on food and water? We're doing okay. Time is looking good too. It's definitely nighttime. This is where I wanted to go. In my previous playthrough, I would not go out at nighttime, and I actually played on a version that made everything darker, but this one is still early access. I guess the other one technically was also, but at any rate, I think I'm just going to try and learn the game. It is a blind playthrough. That's part of the fun, is like, let's just doodle around and find out how this thing works. Oh man, we've got 12 seconds left. I'm under an ice shelf.
Oxygen.
Go back. I don't know how long that ice shelf is. Golly, it's bright out here. Let me look at something, because I have an HDR emulated monitor. It's like a simulated HDR. And you guys are going to have to tell me whether this makes a difference for you or not. This is no bloom, which on my monitor actually looks quite good. But it's not a huge difference. No, it's really not. I'm going to keep the bloom on. But I'll do it one more time. Off. Off. On. I actually don't see a difference right now. We're not looking at anything that shines. Okay, anyway. Pressing on. We need to get into a creepvine forest. I don't think that's the way to go. There's some creepvine. There's some creepvine off in that direction. I only need the creepvine itself, so we'll just go to this one right here. The trusty knife.
New blueprint synthesized. Oxygen.
Okay. I think I got 4 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And we'll head back over here to our life pod. Well, it's not a life pod. I don't really know. It's a habitat, I guess. Base. Our base. Okay, bring this up. Fiber mesh. And O2 tank.
Adding additional blueprints to your data bank. New blueprint synthesized. A standard oxygen tank can be upgraded for deluxe and VIP breathing.
What kind of accent is that? That's a funny... I can't decide if that's a national accent from maybe somewhere Africa, maybe it's hard to tell. It's hard to tell for me. Or if that was actually like a robot sound. It sounds funny to me. So I can't quite place it. I'll go ahead and make this. Might as well.
If you are tired of hearing the word oxygen, the air bladder provides a significant upward thrust to help you get to air faster.
See, it sounds like a blend of different accents, and also that whole auto voice thing that you hear on that people use on YouTube sometimes when they're not confident in their ability to speak the language, so they have a digitized voice that auto translates to English. It sounds like that a little bit too. The rhythms of the speech are weird. Okay. Anyway, first aid kit, that might be worth having. We We got 15 minutes. It sounds like there's a volcano around. Okay, what do I need to make now? How about a compass? I would need a wiring kit. Table coral, gold, and copper wire. And we also need the ribbon plant. Oh, you know what I need first? Probably the thing I need first is a scanning tool. Okay, battery and titanium. We've already got the titanium. We need ribbon plant. How am I doing on... Okay, let's drink some water. It's daytime again. Ribbon plant is going to be down on the surface, the ocean floor. Lots of resources, man. Lots of them. Okay, we got 57 seconds remaining of oxygen. Violet bow. This ribbon plant's gonna... There's some. Take the quartz.
Ribbon plants contain electrolytic materials that can be used in energy storage.
Okay. We're gonna probably need a number of those, because batteries are important.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, that's a convenient warning to have. I like that. Okay, you can see I'm not banging at 60 FPS. We're around 40 to 45, and that's because I've got this playing at 4K on a 4K monitor. If I had it to do over again, guys, I would not have gotten a 4K monitor. I should have gotten a 2K. I think that's where the sweet spot of gaming is at, although we are moving forward. With the latest cards, we're moving forward, but that was a regrettable mistake on my part. But, be that as it may, it doesn't seem to affect how the game looks. So we'll make a battery. Then we'll come down here and we'll make a scanner. Alright.
Alright, I have a scanner.
There's
a battery in titanium. Now comes a scanner. Every xenobiologist's favorite tool. This planet has some fascinating flora and fauna. And I can't wait to learn about them. This will also give me access to a greater tool set. I'm assuming Altera left behind tech that I can scan for blueprints. That should make surviving and exploring out here a bit easier. Don't worry, Sam. I haven't forgotten I'm here for you. But it can't hurt to do a little research on the side, right? I know you would have done the same. I will find out what happened to you. I promise.
All right, so our girl has a science background, and she's naturally excited about new life. That's her wheelhouse.
Oh, thank goodness, fins. Humans are built all backwards for swimming. Our biggest muscles are in our legs, but our thrust comes from our puny, unwebbed hands. No, thank you. Not anymore. Now I can get around and explore with something approaching a reasonable pace. With a little luck, this won't be the last of my speed upgrades either.
That's right, because humans were given the best weapon of all, a brain. And we can figure out workarounds. Alright. That's why you can exit your natural habitat and keep up with everything else, because we find machines that will do that for us. We invent them. Invent them! Twisted Mandrake. Okay. We can learn new blueprints by scanning stuff. Pink Narrow Leaf. Alright. What am I looking for? I messed up. there's the... This, I think, is the kind of coral... No? When it comes to table coral, we'll have to find out where that's at. Okay, what do we got here? 9:46 left, about 10 minutes. Take battery off. Silver wiring kits, I would like to have a compass. So we need copper wire and a wiring kit. Copper wire, wiring kit, okay. Do I have anything in storage? No, let's put this quartz in there. And the lead in the glass, okay, blah, blah, blah. Ribbon plant, keep this other stuff on me. I'm not sure what these green circles mean. Maybe that means they're upgradable. Okay, we need two copper and two silver. Copper should be easy to find. Oh no, that was the wrong one. Red wort. We have sounds in the local area that don't sound friendly. Okay, copper and silver. Silver. Yeah, just silver. My brain kind of froze because I heard something roaring and I wanted... there's like lots of sounds. None of them make me feel comfortable. Okay, we got 12 seconds left.
Oxygen.
You know what? That seems about the same time as original Subnautica. Okay. What are you? Sea monkey. Okay, not dangerous, evidently. Hello. What?
Some of the wildlife down here is very grabby.
Give that back.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Okay. We have some audio hiccups. With 30 seconds, let's re-up on oxygen. Is that a ruby or an egg down there? Right there. That's an alien egg. I'm not interested in a creature egg right now, but I do want to go down here. Radiant sieve coral. Calaverite outcropping. Chance of gold, I think it said. Kelp root.
Warning. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Stay away from me. Okay. Got a little bit more oxygen. Think I can look around a little bit more. Oh, a sea monkey nest.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Probably gotta go. Oh man, aren't I fortunate? I was scared that I wasn't gonna find a way up.
Oxygen.
It's very unforgiving out here. We got freezing rain. Gosh. Oh, that's another egg. Okay, so zero silver so far. Here's this long ice shelf. What is this? Oh man, you're frozen in that. Oh snap! Oh, we were turned into solid ice. I can't move. How much oxygen? 27 seconds? Okay. That's a potentially dangerous aspect of our environment. Makes noises like that. We need silver. What does silver come from? Man, am I getting closer to something that might eat me? Looking at blueprints. Yeah, it doesn't really tell me what I find silver in, what kind of node. I thought it was, we're on the same planet. It should be the same stone, the sandstone. That sounds terrible. Maybe they're just whales. Oh, whoops. Seconds left. I'm running into a lot of limestone, but not any sandstone. Another cave. Oh, have I been here? Sea glide fragment.
Okay. New blueprint synthesized.
We can make that now. Everything is limestone. This looks rather extensive. And the music changed. We might have switched biomes. Oh, we have wreckage. We're in a different area. Is this safe? I would not go here if I didn't have to, but I need to find silver, and I don't think that's in the initial biome. I didn't see very much sandstone. Oh, look how deep it goes. This is the telltale sign of Subnautica. The deeper things get, the more sketchy they get. Oh, gosh. Oh, God. Go. not being chased. Okay, timer's gone off. Yikes. Duh. Man, there's stuff there. Okay, we're 200 meters. I don't know what direction, though, because I don't have that compass yet. Okay, well, I think I want to stay kind of generally right here. Do I have food on me? No fishies? No fishies. Oh, so much for that. We need to go back. Let's go ahead and, I think what I'll do, you guys don't really need to see all that. I will save it. And then we're going to call it an episode right here, but I am going back to the base and I'm going to do some fishing and get food and water. And we will continue looking for silver in the next episode. Again, I'm Aesop Grimm. Thanks for coming by the channel. I hope you like what you saw. I am in the process of canvassing my subscribers to find out what you guys like, what you want to see. I don't know how much replayability this episode has, but if you want to see more Subnautica Below Zero in the future, give a like and a comment. I kind of doubt that it's got huge replayability, so I'm sort of depending on you guys for that. But also, if you just want to help the channel, give a like and a comment, and or a comment. Anyway, I will see you guys in the next episode where this story continues. Thanks for visiting Aesop Grimm's Chronicles. If you've made it this far in the video, please consider rating, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. I hope to see you in the next episode, and until then, stay shiny.